Students, I hope you are all in the pink of health. I feel on cloud nine to meet you all again through this video. Already in the first video, we have seen Unit 1, Prose Part, Two Gentlemen of Verona. In the same unit, we are going to cover the poem part actually, The Castle, which is written by Edwin Muir. What is the title of the poem? The Castle, which is written by Edwin Muir. See, before I enter into the poem, you should always have the clarity over the title. Do you have any idea about the title? The Castle. See, Castle, let me go with the answer. Castle. Castle is nothing but a large building which contains high walls, thick gates, sometimes movers, moat, bafflements and so on. And then, it is a royal residence. In those days, past and all, it was built over in order to defend people from attack. In order to safeguard the people, people were built over. Understood? So, that only we call it as castle. Okay? And then, which is written by Edwin Muir. Okay. Before we enter into the poem, I told already, usually I will say this, we should always appreciate the one who is responsible for the work. It is nothing, none other than Edwin Muir. Actually, coming to Edwin Muir, he belongs to Scotland. He is a Scottish poet. Not only poet, he is also a dramatist who has written dramas, novelist. He has written many novels, as well as he was being as a critic, translator, and so many roles he had. Understood? And at the age of 14, he lost everybody in his family. Okay, one by one, he lost everybody in his family and he was forced to work in factories as a heavy work he has done over in order to save his life. Okay, in order to take care of his daily needs. That bitter experience made him to write, enter his career into poetry, not poetry, writing field actually. And later on, he started to establish all those things, okay, everything, the sufferings which he has meant of through his writing he expressed. And when we come to his themes actually, most of these themes he focused on death, loss, disloyalty, life, all those things. Because he had such kind of life, so he has projected in his work. Understood? Okay, it is one of the best work, The Castle, one of the best work of Edwin Muir. In this poem, he has clearly picturized actually the majestic castle and they were very confident about the strength of the castle, the mighty castle it was. And at the end, it was defeated, it was captured, overthrown by the enemies. How it has happened over everything he has given in six stanzas one by one. Okay, in this poem, first three stanzas, he has covered over the soldiers, the armies, and how about the strength they had. Everything the poet has highlighted in the three stanzas. If you have the clear clarity over the poem, if I explain line by line, stanza wise, you will get it off. Okay, shall we go with? Okay, line by line, as a stanza wise, line by line explanation, now I am going to move on with. Understood children, so far, this poem is all about the castle and it has been defeated and overthrown all of a sudden. And how it had happened, everything we are going to see. What is the theme of the poem in the sense? It is an unspecified battle. You will come to know why the poet has said so. Okay, why he has picturized so, everything we are going to see. Let me go with stanza 1. Okay, what is the first stanza explains in the sense? See, I just read out, you just have a glance, one by one, line by line. All through the summer, at ease we lay. And one more thing I want to say. See here, who is narrating the story in the sense? In the castle, soldiers were being there. Okay, the narrator was a soldier, one among the soldiers. So many were there in the castle and the narrator was one among the soldiers. Understood? So, he is narrating the poem. So now we'll see, all through the summer at ease we lay. So it was a summer time. Okay, It was a summer time, and all through the summer, which means that throughout the summer, at ease we lay. See, for your better understanding, I have given the glossary even one by one, stanza wise actually, I have divided. Just have a glance, even the glossary also. Now just listen, it was a summer time, at ease we lay. We were very comfortable and we were stress free and relaxed. How we were spending our time? We were very relaxed and stress free. Okay, it was a summer time, we were being in a relaxed way. We in the sense here, we refers to the soldiers who were being there in the castle. Have you understood, children? Okay, first line, the very first line of the poem, at ease we lay, in the sense it is nothing but stress free and comfortable. Okay, and then and daily from the turret wall. See, daily they are doing that work. See, in the turret wall is nothing but, I have given even, tower on the top of the castle. See, if you see the appearance of the castle, the infrastructure of the castle, you will even come to know. See, each and every castle, they will be having the tower over on the top of the castle. What the soldiers will do, in the sense, they will stand over there and they will get a clear view. Okay, so each and every castle, you will come across this turret wall actually. So where they are being over, the soldiers were standing on the top of the castle, and how many days? Daily they are doing that work actually, as a routine work they are doing that, and they are watching. What they are watching? Now you have the question in your mind. We watch the mowers in the hay. We, in the sense, again the we refers to the soldiers. So we watched, what we were watching of? The mowers in the hay. Mowers nothing but, see here I have given, people who trim grass and level the lawns. See, when they were standing over, they could see the grassland which is covered over near the castle, and people who were leveling the grass actually. Okay, mowers in the sense, people who were leveling the grass. Even the machines also, we can say, the machine, they will use with the help of the machine and level the grass. Mowers in the sense, we can take both of it actually. So people were leveling the grass, and by standing the top of the castle, the soldiers could watch even the mowers in the hay. Understood? And the enemy half a mile away. See, when they were standing over on the top of the wall, not only they could watch the mowers, even the enemies also. The sole purpose of standing over there and watching is in order to watch the enemies, not the mowers actually. When they were standing over, they could see even the mowers. But where they are actually, where they are watching, see, whether the enemies are being over there, they were very watchful. They, in the sense here, soldiers, they were very watchful. And half a mile away, their focus, they could focus on half a mile distance. So till that distance, there were no enemies, which means that they were very confident. See, the view, overall view, we could see that there were no enemies, which means that, understood? And they seemed no threat as at all. So they seemed, in the sense, the enemies. We don't want to fear of the enemies. We don't have any kind of fear at all. Because, see, throughout wherever we are seeing, we couldn't see any kind of enemies which were hiding over in order to come and attack over the castle. So we were very stress-free. We were very much relaxed. And we were very comfortable in the summer time. Where we were standing over, we were standing on the turret wall on the top of the castle, and what we were watching of? Mowers as well as the enemies. And one more thing, really we feel very comfortable. We don't have any fear at all, because half a mile distance there were no enemies. Have you understood the first stanza of the poem, children? I understood. See, even you can go through the glossary, it will be helpful for you in order to relate the meaning. Understood? Then, second stanza. Let us move on with the second stanza, stanza 2. For what we thought had we to fear? We thought, see, we were thinking of why should we afraid of? Fear in the sense a kind of frightening. Okay, why should we get afraid of? See, no enemy and nobody was there in the near the castle. So why should we afraid of? We were thinking of, we don't want to get fear because we were very much relaxed. And then with our arms and provender load on load. See, arms is nothing but here weapons. We have plenty of weapons. We kept everything ready. Not only that, arms, weapons along with provender. Provender is nothing but food. I mentioned over there in the glossary part. Provender is nothing but food. Okay, they save the, actually they store the food. They have the provisions in stock, which means load on load in the sense that they have kept as a stock. So arms, they have weapons as well as the food, they kept as a stock, which means that they were kept ready in order to face anybody. Okay, they don't want to depend upon anyone. They don't want to move up from the place because everything which was available over there in the castle. So we don't want to get afraid of. Then our towering battlements, tier on tier. See, towering battlements is nothing but tall towers with openings to shoot enemies. Tall towers with openings to shoot enemies. See, when you see the outer structure of the castle, actually you will come to know. See, you will have some layers. Outer part, you will have some layers. See, each and every layer, you will have some hole. What for in the sense? See, the soldiers, they will hide over there in the place and they will start to attack. So, it will be having some layers in the castle if you look over. So, see, towering battlements, tall towers with openings. Each and everywhere, you will find some openings. Okay, by standing over there, they will start to attack. So, tier on tier, one above the other. Tier on tier means one above the other. Okay, then, and friendly allies drawing near. Friendly allies is nothing but, again I mentioned over, helpful or supporting nations. See, from the beginning they are saying that, see, we are standing on the turret wall watching the enemies as well as the movers. No enemies half a distance. See, half a distance away sometime they would have been, but see, throughout the play, throughout the view, actually we couldn't see any kind of enemies. And then we are not getting afraid of. Not only for that, we have enough arms, weapons and then provender, food we kept as a stock, so we don't have any kind of fear. And then we have our towering battlements which is kept over in order to attack the enemies if they come over, in order to capture. Okay, they were standing over. And then, and friendly, and not only that, we have our supportive nations. Actually some nations are nearby, they were ready to support us on every leafy road, which means that they were coming near nearer in order to support us all the way through. Actually leafy road in the sense, on that side actually, okay, they were coming off with the help of the roads, each and everywhere, wherever they wanted to come, they were ready to enter. The supporting nations, they were getting ready in order to help us, support us if we have really have any need. If you are in need of, really they were being ready in order to help us. So arms in the sense weapons is nothing but food, soldiers and everything, supporting nations, all sort of strength we have in our hand, so we don't have any kind of fear. That is why daily we are standing over and we were stress free and relaxed. Understood, children? So far I have covered two stanzas from the poem. Now let us move on to the third stanza. See, just look over. Our gates were strong, our walls were thick. And one more thing I want to say, these are all, these two stanzas we could see the confident of the soldiers as well as the food, the arms which they had, the power it denotes. And in this stanza we are going to see the strength of the castle, how strong the castle was. Just look at our gates were strong. How about the gates of the castle? Very strong actually. And then our walls were thick. We have very thick walls. The walls of the castle were very thick, and the gates actually, the gates were very strong and so smooth and high. See, not only that, why the poet stressed over the particular word smooth? See, smooth in the sense it will be really, see, we cannot climb that much easily. Okay, if the space is anything which is very smooth in the sense, we never even find easy to climb on. So, not only that, it is very smooth and high too. See, if it is very short, even at somehow you could manage and get climb over. But here there is no such thing in order to enter over, because see, gates were strong. You cannot break off the gates of the castle, and the walls you cannot even break off actually. And then smooth, it is very difficult to climb over. And then high you cannot even reach in order to enter over. And no man could win a foothold there. See here, even no man could win a foothold there. Foothold is nothing but advantageous position. Any kind of thing, whatever it may be, anything which you people brought in order to enter into the castle, that is highly impossible. See, no man could win. Nobody can win over the castle and enter into it. And then, no clever trick could take us dead or quick. No clever trick. See, if you make any plans, okay, any plans in a cunning way, clever trick if you implement in order to enter into the castle, as well as, see, could take us dead or quick. Quick in the sense, usually the synonymous meaning is fast. Quick in the sense, fast we will say. Here it is a olden usage, English actually, olden English, which means alive. Okay, quick in the sense, alive. See, if anybody, nobody, it's a challenging one. What is the challenge? What is the challenge? Okay, nobody could enter into the castle, as well as any kind of clever trick if they are making off in order to enter into the castle. They cannot even do it off, and they cannot even come and take us dead or alive. Even alive or dead, if you come and kill us or us to take us alive, they cannot even do it off. It is highly impossible. And then, only a bird could have gotten. See, here he is making a kind of challenge. Only a bird could have gotten. Why he is telling only a bird could have gotten? We cannot stop the movement, resist the movements of the bird actually. Okay, bird in the sense, it will fly over and enter inside the castle. Okay, apart from that, nobody can defeat over the castle with a trick or any kind of thing. They cannot enter into it. As a human being, they cannot come directly and win over the castle. Only a bird could have enter into the castle, because that too why he is telling, in a sense, birds are not have the ability to fly actually. So maybe the birds will fly over and enter into the castle, but in a direct way, by using any trick or any other thing, they cannot easily enter into the castle. Have you understood, children? Let me have a see. Once again I'll clarify it off. All through the summer, it was the summer time. All through the summer, we innocent soldiers, who is narrating the story? Yes, a soldier who was being one among the soldiers. Okay, a soldier was being over there, and he is narrating the story towards the readers. Understood? So we were being there, and we were very watchful, and all through the summer we were stress free and relaxed, because we have everything in our hand, food, weapons, and everything, we got it ready, and we don't want to get afraid of no enemies. We could see even half a mile distance, there were no enemies, so we were very much confident actually. And then we have some supportive nations, and then we kept everything ready, so no need to get afraid of. And one more thing, these are all, it says about the confidence of the soldiers. And then the provisions which they have have kept in prayer in order to safeguard themselves. Here in third stanza, you could see the outer strength of the castle. Okay, gates were strong and walls were thick walls, smooth as well as very high, so that no man could enter into it, and then they cannot even take the soldiers or anybody in the castle, dead or alive. As well as one more thing I want to say, even birds alone, okay, only the birds can enter into the castle. That too, we cannot resist to stop the movement of the bird, and it has the tendency to fly over, it can enter. Okay, apart from that, nobody can enter into the castle. I have given the synonym glossary also, okay, even you may go through for better clarification. Next, stanza 4 we are going to see. See, what could they offer as for bait? Here, they refers to the enemies and us refers the soldiers who are being there in the castle. Okay, what the enemies could offer us to give us as a bait. Bait is nothing but the meaning I have given, just listen. Intent to entice someone to do something. I'll give one example for bait. See, if you are using angler in order to catch fish actually. Okay, you are using angler in order to catch fish. And the end of the hook actually. Okay, what you will do? You will use worms in order to catch the fishes. Understood? So, you are giving something in order to get something. You are giving in the sense, you are giving the worms in order to get fishes. Am I right? So, one of the soldier, the one who is narrating the poem, is telling what the enemies could offer us to give us in order to get the things from us. Understood? Okay? Then, our captain was brave and we were true. Our captain in the sense, they are saying as the soldiers. See, our captain, okay, the one who is leading the team, our captain, he was brave. Brave is something courageous. And then, and we were true. Okay, we were very much truthful to our profession. Okay, we were being as a soldiers, we were very much truthful in our profession towards our captain, the one who is leading the team. And then, there was a little private gate. Okay, here only the turning point of the poem we are going to see actually. Just have a keen observation towards this. From here, there is a change happen over. Okay, just listen. There was a little private gate. Little in the sense small, private gate in the sense secret gate. Okay, there was a small secret gate, and then a little wicked gate actually. Just see, you have only the spelling differs here. Here D and here T. Wicked in the sense evil, bad. Okay, that only it denotes wicked. And then wicked gate in the sense small gate. Here I have mentioned over wicked gate in the sense small gate. D in the sense evil, T in the sense a small gate. T here it refers, so you may correlate with, okay, if you have any confusion. And then a little wicked evil, and then wicked gate, a small gate. The wizened warder. Wizened is nothing but wrinkled. Okay, wrinkled is something, it denotes the age. So old warder. Warder is nothing but a guard. Okay, there was an old guard. Let them through. He allowed them through. Them in the sense here it refers the enemies. Through, which means that he allowed the enemies to enter into the castle with the help of the small private gate, secret gate. Okay, understood? Which means that he has received bribery from the enemies for money or some other thing, gold or whatever it may be. He has received a bribe from the enemies and he allowed the enemies in order to enter into the castle with the help of the small private gate. Private is nothing but secret gate. And then, have you understood the fourth stanza, children? There was an old wardener, wizened in the sense, it denotes the skin actually, wrinkled appearance. Old it denotes actually. He allowed, let in the sense allowing,
them in the sense enemy. Through in the sense, through the private gate, he made the enemies to enter into the castle. Now everything has got over. See the secret, whatever they maintained, whatever confidence they had in their mind, everything has been destroyed because of the act of the evil, wicked, wizened wardener. Understood? And then stanza 5 will see. Oh, then our maze of tunneled stone grew thin and treacherous as air. Just look over, it is very important. Oh, then, now, what happened? Maze. Maze is nothing but a confusing or intricating path. For example, see some games and all you will come to know. Directly you cannot reach it off actually. See, it is very tough to identify the path actually. So usually in castle they'll build in such a way only. What for? In the sense, enemies if they enter even also, they cannot directly enter into it. They'll get confusion over there because the path will be really confused. Sometimes the path which they are leading off, they'll make them to come off again. They cannot move inside, they can come back again in the same way. Such a type the buildings and all they built over. So here our maze, confusing path of a tunneled stone. Tunneled also here, the secret pathways actually underground. The secret things, whatever they built off in order to maintain as a secret, grew thin. Now it has become thin. How strong castle it was, okay? Thick gates and high walls, everything they kept as ready in order to attack the enemies. Now it grew thin, the walls of the castle grew thin because of the enemies, because easily they entered into the castle. And treacherous is air. Treacherous is nothing but disloyalty. As air, like air. Air is, see, you cannot see the air is present over here in one place or there. Everywhere, wherever we see, the air is surrounded with. The same way, disloyalty has been surrounded over the entire place because of the old wizened wardener. Understood? Treacherous is nothing but disloyalty. And then maze in the sense intricating or confusing path. And the cause was lost. What was the cause of the castle actually? In our cause of the soldiers actually. What is the main purpose of the soldiers? In order to protect the castle from the enemies. That main sole cause was lost now because the enemies already entered. Without a groan. Groan is nothing but lamentation or cry. See, they didn't shed blood, they didn't face any kind of pain. See, it is an unspecified battle. I told already in the earlier, the theme, actual theme of the poem is unspecified battle. Now you people came to know, I think. Okay, they didn't specify, they specifically they didn't come to know the enemies are going to attack the castle. Everything happened over without the knowledge of the soldiers and all of them were being there in the castle. It is because of only the wizened old guard who were being there in order to maintain the private gate. Groan in the sense cry. So without any cry or any pain, okay, the mighty castle, okay, defeated. Then the famous citadel overthrown. Citadel is nothing but fort actually. See, even castle, citadel and fort, all are synonyms meaning only. So what happened here? Without groan, our famous citadel, okay, this castle is meant for all sort of things actually. Okay, we can say proudly that our castle is really strong and majestic. But that castle, majestic castle, okay, now overthrown, captured by the enemies. Understood? And then, and all its secret galleries were, whatever they kept as a secret, whatever they maintained so far, protected from the enemies, everything became bare, empty. Now, okay, because everything taken over by the enemies. Now, answer 6. Just look over. How can this shameful tale be told? Okay, how can we tell this tale in the same story? See, because of the old gardener, old god, here he was the one who is working here, okay, in the castle. He was the one who is protecting, not working actually, protecting the castle, maintaining the castle, and he himself revealed the secret to the enemy's far right actually. So, how can this shameful tale to be told? He is raising the question. And then, I will maintain until my death. Here the narrator is telling, I will maintain, I never say the secret to anyone. I maintain the secret till my death. Till the end of my life, I will maintain this as a secret. And then, we could do nothing being sold. Now, this is the position, okay, this is the situation, we cannot do anything at all. Now, we are being sold. Already our enemies, okay, the enemies, they have taken away the things, everything from us, and they have captured the castle. So, we cannot do anything at all. We are already sold off in the hands of the enemies. And then, our only enemy was gold. Here, the old gardener, he was the one who is responsible for this. But what for they have entered into the castle? It is only for the gold, the treasury, okay, the important things, all that whatever they kept over inside the castle in order to capture all those things. They have entered into the castle with the help of the old guard. So here they are telling, so who was our real enemy? Gold here. For the gold only they have entered, they captured the castle. And then, and we had no arms to fight with. Now, how about our situation? Arms in the sense weapon. We don't have any weapons to fight against them. Already we lost our confidence. See, everywhere we could see only disloyalty. It has spread over like air. Okay, so we don't have anything to do with now. Only thing is we have to surrender in front of the enemy. So already the castle had been captured by enemies. It is only because of the old wizened gardener. He has received the bribe from the enemies and he allowed the enemies to enter into the castle. So, have you understood, children, the overall poem? It is a very interesting poem. So far, we have seen six stanzas. See how he has started, first three, okay, he has given all sort of the strength, okay, the confident, how about the soldiers were, everything we have covered. And then the second part of the poem, next three stanzas, the fall of the mighty castle. I want to give one thing I want to convey, last thing, this is what, usually, greediness here, see, the greediness of the old wizened gardener. Greediness not only spoils the castle but everything. Okay, have you understood the overall poem, children? Okay, I hope that you will get the clear cut idea. Further, if you have any clarification towards this particular poem, you may even refer the glossary and line by line explanation I have given. Just observe the entire video, okay, and then I hope that you people will get the clear cut idea about this poem. Okay, thank you all.